Get excited because One Chicago Wednesdays are making their way back to Channel 11 for all new seasons, stories, and more. And we are lucky enough to be joined by a few of the stars from all three shows, Brian T., Kara Kilmer, and LaRoyce Hawken. You guys, each of you will start with Chicago Med, Fire, then PD. One word to describe the upcoming season.
Important.
Responsibility.
Resilience.
I love it. I love it. These are all great things to work off of here because obviously all of us as Chi-Hards are super excited to have you all back in our homes on Wednesday night. You guys have such a big ability to impact fans on such a large level. What do you each want people to take away from these seasons?
The way the shows are written, it's very current. It's people are going to watch our show and they're going to feel like, okay, they understand what all of us are feeling, all of the anxiety and just the uncertainty that we're all under. So I think our shows, all three of our shows, will be very expositional in terms of like, yes, we see what you see and we're going through it too. But I also think that we have this unique ability to not just be honest about what's happening, but also aspirational, like being able to show this is how we want first responders to respond to the world that we're in right now. And so we're striking the balance between like being honest about the things that are going on, but also trying to paint a picture for like, this is who we could be and this is who we want to be.
I agree with that fully. And then do you guys also feel like you might be drawing even more fans in now? People have been looking for that relief. They've been binge watching. You have a whole new set of fans that are entering the picture, excited to see what's happening.
Yeah. I think that's the hope every season, but I think, especially this season, I think with the circumstances, with the social unrest all the way down to the pandemic, you know, we're literally dealing with the people on the front lines and the first responders. And that's who we all kind of portray. And we take deep responsibility, especially this season, to really try to tell our stories in a very authentic way. And in the end, hopefully really show our audience and the new audiences coming in, you know, that we can all kind of learn and grow together.
In addition to all of this too, I want to dive into some of your characters here because those previews that you guys just released are insane. Each of you specifically, because obviously we have you guys on the front lines in the midst of the pandemic and the social unrest, and there's a whole bunch of things happening. We'll go down to LaRoyce here because we haven't heard from you much yet. What can we expect for Atwater coming back into the picture moving forward?
Man, we can expect Atwater. We can expect Atwater to definitely grow. I call this season Atwater's awakening a little bit, right? Like, I think we see him become a lot more calculated and strategic and intentional about not just how he does his best to infiltrate the blue wall of policing, but in the way that he starts to carry better habits into the way that he polices. Like I said, like Kara was saying, we have an opportunity to help our audience reimagine the way these professions are carried out, hopefully in a positive direction. Atwater is struggling naturally based off of everything that has happened to him from the season finale to now, with even whether he wants to be a cop anymore in a lot of ways. Like, what's the point at this juncture of his journey? And so I think if he decides to continue moving forward being a police officer, he's gonna have to find a very powerful why. And I think if his why is big enough to teach us all something, then he's doing it for the right reasons.
The beautiful thing about the writers on these shows, they're not shying away from bringing anything to light, from talking about things. I think that's very important, especially now. Just open that discussion because people look to you guys and your shows on Chicago Med, Fire, and PD for that sense of relatability, for that sense of comfort. and even that sense of the drama that comes with it. And I think that you guys have such a good platform to keep spreading that positivity and bringing those issues, starting those conversations, which of course we cannot wait to see moving forward. Before we go to, do you guys have any idea if there are going to be any Chicago crossovers in the work?
You know, Brian talked about it being like, we have this at least through line, this thematic through line of all three of the shows dealing with the pandemic. So we're all connected.
Chicago, one family, baby.
Can we just have a quick shout out to all of your fans out here in Pittsburgh who are so excited to have you?
Hi, fans in Pittsburgh.
Y'all know I love y'all, man.
Please, Wednesday nights.